Because they marched, America became more free and more fair, not just for African Americans, but for women and Latinos, Asians and Native Americans, for Catholics, Jews, and Muslims.
In 1963, hundreds of thousands of people marched on Washington demanding equality and freedom in the middle of the civil rights movement. Now, 50 years later, thousands flocked to that same spot to celebrate some remarkable progress and reflect on a historic moment. And several Mainers made that journey to Washington a half century ago. WMTW News 8's Paul Merrill spoke with one of them today, and he joins us now live with more. Paul.
Tracy, at first, Gerald Talbot said he didn't think he'd be able to make the trip to Washington. He needed time off from work and permission from his wife. Both his boss and his wife agreed to help him with his plans, and he found himself on a bus heading south to be a part of history. Gerald Talbot was just yards from the podium when Martin Luther King Jr. delivered those historic lines 50 years ago today.
Well, Dr. King's speech just electrified the 250,000 people. And I was just one of them. And it just electrifies you. It electrified you from the bottom of your feet to the top of your head.
Talbot was in his early 30s, and a local pastor invited him to attend the March on Washington. In our nation's capital, Talbot realized there was something missing from his sign.
Somebody's got to put on the word Maine.
Talbot got a pen and made the changes that you can still see in this picture.
As we're marching down, there are people lined on both sides of the street, right? And they were saying, and they could read that sign. And the reason why I say that is because they were saying, where's Maine? What's Maine?
Talbot says the trip changed his life. He was determined to bring Dr. King's message back to Maine. Talbot got more involved in the Portland community and became Maine's first African-American state representative. Now, 50 years later, Talbot reflects on how Dr. King's words changed our nation.
His dream is still there. It always will be there, but the dream has got to continue to be the dream that's got to come true.
Talbot says the challenge moving forward is for people to abandon apathy and work to make their communities better.
If somebody is living in poverty, if somebody isn't going to school or should be going to school or isn't getting the education that they should be getting and have to get to go on, it's our problem, our problem. Our problem as a community.
Talbot says he still finds it fascinating when he meets new people who also attended the March on Washington, and they can share their stories about where exactly they were on that day 50 years ago. Live in the studio, Paul Merrill, WMTW News 8.